You want the tooth? You can't handle the tooth of these gears! Friends, Romans, countrymen, lend me your gears? That's right, gang. This week we're talking about my second favorite thing to grind, gears. Gears are super old. The first ones we know of were on a chariot in China from maybe the 27th century BC under mythical Chinese emperor Huang Di. But that's not to say they're not older than that. And before they were invented, if you told somebody to get it into gear, well, they had no idea what you're talking about. These days, there's all kinds of gears. There's miter gears, worm drive gears, herringbone gears, rocket peanut gears, rain gears that help Santa fly, gears of war, gears for fears, craft gear lovers, happy new gear, New Year's Eve, pierced gears, gear in the headlights, John gear, power gearing, legendary Seattle supersonic, Geary Payton, and bevel gears. There's more types of gears than there's types of people in the world, left-handed and right-handed. Today, we're focusing on two very special types of gears, straight-cut gears, sometimes called spur gears, and helical gears. And I guess we're also going to be tackling some tough issues and having a discussion about race. No? All right, everybody's shaking their heads no and mouthing racing. All right, we're going to be talking about racing. Right now, you're probably asking yourself, what the heck are straight gears and helical gears? That's right, I knew what you're thinking because I can read your thoughts. Now you're thinking, how did he read my thoughts? Well, it's a genetic mutation I got because my mom used the microwave when she was pregnant. Now, you're thinking that you should tell your dad that you love him. Don't, he might not say it back. Helical gears are the type of gears found in the transmission of almost all vehicles on the road. And I say almost because there's a few cars out there that prefer straight cut gears. These are a special type of car that are used to race other cars in races to see who can go fastest within the confines of a race. And I think those cars are called cars that like to go fast. The teeth on a helical gear are angled, and the teeth on a straight cut go straight out. So a helical gear can absorb contact smoothly and spread it out. And straight cut gets it all at once. It's the difference between jumping in an ice bath or getting in slowly, or ripping a Band-Aid off real quick, or taking your time, or building up to telling your mom you're never gonna be an astronaut doctor, or just blurting it out. Sorry, Mom, I'm a garage scientist. So why would some cars want straight cut gears instead of helical? Man, if only there was some sort of weekly show presenting information like that in an entertaining fashion that people can complain about. Wait a minute, I have a CGI creation that lives in a program just like that. So helical gears are cylindrical gears whose teeth are not parallel to the axis of rotation. They're cut at an angle to the face of the gear. The teeth are angled and appear as a segment of a helix, so they have helical teeth. The angle between the teeth and the axis of the gear is called the helix angle, which normally ranges from 15 to 45 degrees. On these gears, there's two pressure angles, transverse plane pressure angle and normal plane pressure angle. The module and circular pitch of helical gears are defined on the transverse plane. They're designed to distribute pressure gradually along the whole tooth. When two teeth on a helical gear system engage, the contact starts at one end of the tooth and gradually spreads as the gears rotate until the two teeth are in full engagement. This gradual engagement makes helical gears operate much more smoothly and quietly than other gears. And that's the reason helical gears are used in almost all car transmission. They make enough contact to transfer power and they're quiet. And helical gears can also be mounted on perpendicular shafts. So you adjust the rotation angle by 90 degrees. They're quieter there too. And they can transmit energy between parallel or perpendicular axes. In any running system with a shaft and a bearing, there's usually loads in two directions. One in the direction of the axis of rotation, and the other radially. Thrust is the net force along the axis of rotation. Because of the helix and the teeth of helical gears, while the gears mesh, thrust force is developed axially. These forces push the gear toward the bearing. Hence, a thrust bearing has to be placed in the direction of axial force. The axial thrust bearings have to be able to resist the developed thrust forces. And this restricts the amount of torque that can be applied through the gears before failures occur. The axial load produced by helical gears diminishes the output energy from the transmission. They also have a slight increase in friction, so we get to lose some more power as heat. Now let's contrast that with straight cut gears. But before we do, why don't you guys hit the subscribe button so that we can keep working hard to bring you stuff like this. The name explains it all, really. The actual teeth of the gears point straight out from the center of the gear. They go straight out. A lot of people think that straight cut gears are stronger than helical gears, and that's why they're used. Well, a lot of people don't drink Mr. Pibb, think that good deeds are rewarded, and think it's a good idea to get involved in a land war in Asia. And all these people are wrong. Race transmission with straight cut gears are usually strong, but it's not because of the teeth on the gear. Straight cut gears are actually slightly weaker than a same sized helical gear. Shut up! Let me finish. Helical gears have more teeth meshing, so they have got a greater load-bearing surface area. Also, the difference in efficiency is pretty negligible. Both spur and helical gears have about 98 to 99% efficiency. Technically, on a tooth versus tooth comparison, a helical gear can carry a larger load because it's diagonally positioned on the gear, assuming tooth size is equivalent. And that means it distributes the forces applied on it much more efficiently compared to a vertical tooth. So why are straight cut gears used in race transmissions? Because of the axial load from the helical gears. We don't want no axial loads! And straight cut gears don't produce thrust loads. Okay, let's pretend I'm the gear. There's a y-axis going from my head to my feet. That's radial force. There's an x-axis going from elbow to elbow, and that's tangential force. And there's a z-axis going from my chest to my back, and that's axial force. In a straight cut gear, I'd be super skinny. The teeth would just hit my head and mesh instantly. So there is no axial force. Basically, since they don't produce thrust loads, you don't need all the bearings and a big box and heavy crap to absorb and deal with all that axial load. So the transmission is gonna be way, way lighter. Heavy duty transmission casings and shafts gotta be used with helical gears for the transmission to cope with all of those additional loads. So straight cut gears save heaps and heaps of weight, and that is important in racing. A straight cut transmission is generally gonna be more efficient. So, is it strength that makes straight cut gears better for racing? Not really. It's easy to build strong gears either straight or helical. So strength isn't the issue. The problem is when you start putting huge amounts of torque through helical gears, the axial loads get so high that everything else, from transmission case and shafts and the axles, you gotta contain them loads, and that adds all the weight. Straight cut gears simplify almost everything from the transmission case to the design of the bearings needed, and that makes things leaner. And because there's less stuff there, you get a larger powertrain that you can place in a vehicle without risking output shafts and other bearings tearing themselves apart, which is actually making a larger safety factor within the transmission itself. A negative to straight cut gears, and it's why they're not in most street cars, is they produce a lot of noise. You're trading weight for all that noise, and that's no problemo if you're racing. Straight cut gears are also easier to assemble, and they have less catastrophic results when things go wrong because of the simple structure. They're not gonna fly out this way, they're just gonna break. Whew, now. A gearbox with straight cut gears is not necessarily a dog box. I mean, usually they are, but they don't have to be. Dog box refers to how the gears are engaged, and straight cut refers to the type of gears themselves. You wanna learn more about that? Check out the video on dog boxes. Or just buy some donut merch. That's the quickest way to learn. Through osmosis. Helical gear! Thanks to Honey for sponsoring this video. Honey is a browser extension that automatically scours the interwebs for coupon codes to make sure you're getting the best possible deal. You know how you always get to the checkout and it's like, do you have a discount code? And you're like, no. Well, say no, no more. It's super easy to install. It's literally two clicks and it's free. You know how they say you gotta spend money to make money? Well, that may be true, but you don't have to spend money to save money, because Honey costs you nothing. I used it when I bought new rear struts. Honey just patiently sat in the background until I was ready to check out, and when I was, it found a code and saved me mucho moolah. Searching for codes yourself is often fruitless, and it takes all kinds of math. Do I want free shipping or 20% off? Honey does all that for you to make sure you're getting the best deal out there. That means more money for your dragons hatching from egg sculpture collection. And if it doesn't find a coupon code, well, that's because there isn't one. So you can shop confidently knowing you got the best deal out there. There's no reason not to add Honey to your browser today, like now. It literally takes two clicks and costs you no money. Click the link below to add Honey to your browser for free. Or, if you'd rather, type in joinhoney.com/sciencegarage. Honey! Hey guys, click on this link. That means you love us. We got merchandise at shop.donut.media, and we got new stuff coming out every week. Follow us on Twitter and Instagram at Donut Media. Follow me at Bids Bardo. One of my favorite shows is Miracle Whips, and it's new. Check it out here. You like Gears? Check out this Up to Speed on Land Cruiser. Don't tell my wife I'm responsible for the weird sounds in the car.